everyone. Welcome back to Storytime. I'm Teacher Vivian, and today I'm going to be your Storytime teller again. So thank you so much for coming to our Storytime. As you know, maybe you haven't known, but this week and this past week, we've been reading a lot of stories about different Black scientists, because oftentimes Black scientists are erased from history or they're forgotten. We've also made a list in the description box where you can go and find lots of resources on anti-racist books or books about Black scientists. There's also resources on Black-owned bookstores that you can support during this time. And yeah, other ways that we can get educated during this time too. So also, I want to remind you before we get started to like and subscribe to the Lawrence at Home so that you can get more updates on when we go live and we're going to do other cool science stuff. And today we're going to be learning about someone really smart and really cool. And her name is Estella Atekwana. And I'm going to show you the story right now. Like I said, today we're going to be learning about Estella Atekwana, and she's a geophysicist who really rocks. We're going to be learning about what she does with her life currently and what she did to get there. And we're going to learn about what a geophysicist is too. So Estella was born in 1961 in Cameroon, which is a country in Africa. So I've put a picture right here of Cameroon. Africa is pretty far from the United States, but it is a country that is next to other countries in Africa like Nigeria, Chad, and the Central African Republic. When Estella was in school in the 1970s, her teacher told her that women couldn't be geologists because they couldn't do work in the field. Man, I don't know how that makes you feel, but that makes me kind of sad. As a woman who does science, I feel like that's really unfair. Women can do science. Ah, this is an example of sexism. And sexism is a word that describes when someone gets judged or they're told they can't do something because of their sex or their gender. She went to Howard University, which is a historically Black university. Then she got a PhD at Dalhousie University. Wow, seems like she's really educated. Though her teacher said she couldn't do it, she still got a degree in geology. She proved that her teacher was wrong and women can study geology. Ah, so geology, what is it? So geology is the study of the earth and its physical substance, like its crust, its core, and all the rocks on it and stuff like that too. And man, that's really cool. Her teacher told her she couldn't do it, but she did. So her teacher was wrong. Women can do science and they can study geology. And even though she was told all these different things, she really overcame and she was able to make awesome history. Estella studies something called geophysics. Geophysics is the study of physical processes and properties of Earth and how Earth acts in space. So I put a picture here of what the Earth looks like. Have you ever seen a picture like this of the Earth? Sometimes I've only seen pictures of the Earth that looks blue and green, but right here they've kind of cut the Earth into like a cake and a slice, and you can see inside that it has a lot of different layers. It has a crust, a mantle, an outer core, an inner core, and the inside of the Earth is actually really cool. There's a lot of stuff to see. And geophysics also cares about how the Earth acts in the space around it too. So like right here, if you see these lines, this is something called the magnetic field around the Earth. So there's actually a big magnet around the Earth like this, and it has magnetic field lines where we have the South Pole and the North Pole. Estella has taught at many places, sharing her knowledge. She is now a dean at the University of Delaware, which means she leads other many teachers too. She has won many awards for the knowledge about Earth that she's been able to share. And personally, I think this is super inspiring. I want to be a teacher too because I want to share my knowledge. But if you think about the first teacher that told Estella she couldn't do science, man, what if that teacher was right? Well, good thing they weren't. What if Estella maybe heard what that teacher said and just didn't study geology? She wouldn't be able to share all of this knowledge with all these people. I'm really grateful that even though Estella was told by a teacher that she couldn't do it, she became a teacher herself and she became a professor and she taught so many people about geophysics and geology. And that didn't stop her from inspiring other people too. Thank you so much for joining our story. I was really inspired by her. And as a teacher, I hope that I can learn from her too, and also share with other people all the different things we can learn to know more about our world and even make the world better. So Like I said before, in the description box, there's going to be a list of resources that you can use to learn more about other scientists like Estella, or you can learn more about how to be anti-racist. And also, there's that list of all those Black-owned businesses that sell cool books that you can read. So thanks again for coming to Storytime. Please don't forget to like and subscribe to the Lawrence at Home so you can get more updates on when we go live, do other story times, and do other science stuff. I'm Teacher Vivian, signing off. Thanks for coming.